Hi everyone, this is Arun. Welcome back to another video. This is part 2 of the OTBI for Beginners series. In the first video, we saw how to create an analysis using BI Composer. In this video, we will see how to edit the existing analysis using BI Composer. So make sure to watch the first video if you have not done so. All right, let's get started. First thing, log into the instance. So I'm logged into the instance. Let's navigate to Tools, Reports, and Analytics. You should see the analysis that we had created in our first video, and that's invoice details. Click on the options icon, which is all the way to the right, and select edit. And voila, this page should look very familiar to you. This is where we selected the fields from the subject area for our analysis. So in this analysis, we're going to add two more fields. Invoice type name and invoice date. Oh, wait. I know what you're thinking. We already have invoice date field in the analysis. Then why are we adding it again, right? Bear with me for a while and I'll explain why we need that. We will select these fields from the general information folder. Expand invoice details folder and then general information folder. Scroll down and double click invoice type name. Remember, double-clicking the field will move the field to the selected columns area. So first, let's select the invoice type name field. The next step is to, I want to change the invoice type name column header to just invoice type. So highlight invoice type name field. And then let's go to column properties and change the invoice type name column header to invoice type. I hope you remember this from the first video. Now, the next step is to select the invoice date field. Before we do that, let me address the elephant in the room. Why did we add invoice date twice? What we are trying to do is to calculate the number of days based on the invoice date and current date. I want to know how many days have passed since the invoice date. The calculation is current date minus invoice date. First, let's go ahead and select the invoice date field and click on the column properties. Change the column header to days. That's pretty simple, okay? Now let's look at the formula field. We haven't talked about this in our first video, and this is where we will be providing the formula to calculate the number of days. Okay, let's copy the current value from the formula field and paste it to Notepad so that we can take a closer look at it. You'll see it references the field, right? And the format of this text is subject area dot folder name dot field name. Now you know how the data element is being referenced behind the scenes in OTBI. So this is bonus content for you guys. Now we'll be using the function called timestamp diff to calculate the number of days between the two dates. So the formula to calculate the number of days is timestamp diff, SQL, TSI, day, and then date field 1, date field 2. In our case, date field 1 is invoice date, date field 2 is current date. And SQL TSI underscore day, that specifies that we want the difference in days. Now the completed formula should look like this. For current date, there's a system variable which is called current underscore date, and that's what we're going to pass. Let's paste this formula into the formula field. Right, click OK, and then click Next. If the preview option is not selected, make sure to select the preview option. Now you should see the number of days being calculated. That's awesome. So we learned how to include a formula in the analysis. Now let's go to the next section. We didn't do much here last time. This is where we had the option to provide prompts and group by sections, etc. In this analysis, we are going to add a prompt. So go ahead and click the invoice type field and then select move to prompt 4. What you'll also notice is that the records that are being displayed changed. You won't be able to select the different values, that can only be done once you finish the analysis and once you save it and once you view it, okay? So don't worry about it. It's all working. And once you see it, you'll understand better. All right, this is good. And then let's click next and go to the filter and sort section. Let's add one more sort option. This time we select days and select the option descending. Looking at the output, you'll see that we don't need both the sorting options. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete the first sorting option, which is sort by invoice date in descending order. Great, so we learned how to add a new sorting option and also to delete the existing sorting option. That's all the changes that we're gonna do. Click next and then submit. It's gonna ask you to override the existing analysis. That's fine, say yes or okay. All right, now we're back on the reports and analysis homepage. Let's view the report, run the report and check out the output. All right, we can see the prompt and based on the selection, the data is being refreshed and it's working as expected. You can see the number of days being calculated. You will also notice that the sorting option is working correctly and the column highlighting that we defined in part one of this video series, that's also working fine. All right, let's click done and that's gonna take you back to the reports and analytics homepage. In the next video, what we're gonna do is we're gonna create an analysis using BI Analysis Editor and we will try to edit this analysis, the one that we created in this video using BI Analysis Editor. I will explain some of the differences between BI Composer and BI Analysis Editor, and BI Analysis Editor has more features and I'll touch upon a few of them in the next video and we will dive deeper into those features in the subsequent videos. All right. I think that's it for this video. I hope you like this. If you like this, give it a thumbs up. If you love the content that I'm making, please consider subscribing. And I'll talk to you in the next one. Stay safe, stay healthy.